So yesterday I was in a good mood, humming a little Taylor Swift under my breath, thinking life is good. And then I read an email from a friend of mine out east, and everything went south. I was so upset and frustrated, still am. She shared with me her experience of Easter Sunday Mass at her parish. And like most Catholic churches around the world, you get a lot of those, you know, twice a year Catholics, Christmas and Easter. And so her church was packed with people. And this is what she said in her email. At the homily time, the priest spoke about obscure levels of hell that I had never even heard about before and implied that all the people who show up for Mass only on Easter will likely go there, to hell. Seriously, his Easter message was about obligation and hell. You have all these people here and that's your message? I've decided that I cannot continue to go to this church. That was part of her email. So now you know why I went south and got frustrated. But I'm right with you, sister. I would do the same. I mean, you have this amazing opportunity before hundreds, if not thousands, of people you rarely see, and you decide to scold them and shame them into coming back? I'm like, how about making sure the music and the preaching and the hospitality and the welcome are so amazing that when they leave that church of yours, they think, man, I got to come back to this. How about that? But you're going to hell if you don't. Or better yet, how about preaching on God's word rather than your own? And it's all the more tragic to me, considering it was Easter Sunday. You know, along with Christmas, the two feasts in the whole year that are all about the greatness and the amazing love of God in our lives. Right? In one feast, he actually shares the life of his only son with us. And in the other, Easter, he resurrects that life, not for him, for you and for me. That is sacrifice. That is love. And that's the greatness of our God. So, friends, unlike the unfortunate homily my friend out east had to sit through on Easter, today, our Concert Friday is all about tapping into and being reminded of the God who raised his son and blessed us with eternal life. It's all about the greatness of our God. So, the first song, I like it if only for the title alone, Somebody Bigger Than You and I. I love that title. The nature references in the lyrics are awesome, but my favorite part of the lyrics is the shout-out from Easter when he sings, God, he lights the way when the road is long, and with his love to guide you, he walks beside you. Friends, the great Elvis Presley.
Who made the mountain? Who made the trees? Who made the rivers flow to the sea? And who sends the rain when the earth is dry? Somebody bigger than you and I. Who made the flowers? Bloom in the spring. Who made the song for the robins to sing? And who hung the moon in the starry sky?
long. He keeps you company.
Does gospel like Elvis. And I just heard that verse of that last verse, which I really like. And who gives me faith that will never die, somebody bigger than you and I. Amen to that. And that leads us to our second song. That's also a video. I put the link to it in the notes. I just put together clips of the Planet Earth series, which is amazing, and put it to a great song that's, well, simply called How Great is Our God. So I hope you enjoy this, friends. It's so beautiful and reminds us of the great promise and the joy of Easter in this octave. Thanks for joining us today. God's blessing go with you, Father, Son, Spirit. Have a great day. We'll see you tomorrow.
The splendor of a king, clothed in majesty, let all the earth rejoice, all the earth rejoice. He wraps himself in light, and darkness tries to hide, and trembles at his voice, trembles at his voice. How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God? And all will see how great is our God.
and